talking to this guy showing you as a student how to open up a ticket using the Chrome's or the inquiries.cpu.ac.za link and how to open up a new ticket. So first you need to do is you need to click on open a new ticket. It will then take you to a ticket form. The ticket form will be rendered to you, would then ask you to enter your student number. Now you need to remember that you need to put in your student number, right? And this is very important as it's a required field. You need to put in your full name, right? Your email address and your phone number, so that we can reach you in time of emergency, depending on your ticket status. And then when you get to the domain of query, now this is where you need to choose your department. So this would be that you would either be if any of these departments. In this case, you would be information technology. So you would choose information technology, right? You are selecting that. You're linking a list of forms that will open up. You need to direct your query to either to any of these domains. So you either choose the applications development, communication networks, multimedia technology, or you choose any of these general domains. Right? You could also choose advanced diploma if you're doing your BTEC or advanced diploma, postgraduate for masters, and then also if you want to address your matter to the faculty office, you then have to choose any of these options. These are the two faculty members that would assist you related to if it's higher certificate, if it's advanced diploma, if it's postgraduate. And then also if you want to address as for diploma, and diploma falls under first year, second year, third year. So if there's any queries that you want to address to the faculty office, you would then choose that query option. And if you're higher certificate, you choose higher certificate, right? And after you've chosen your query that you direct to, you choose your nature of your query. So if you want to query about exclusion, information request, that means you're asking information. You want to have ask about acknowledgement of achievements that you've done well in a test or exam, and you want to query about that. You have a complaint or grievance. You want to attach a medical certificate. That means that you have been absent for a test or an exam, or you have not been around attending classes. Then you choose that nature of query, or if you want to report submission and also any other, you can choose other if you have no other reasons regarding the nature of query. Then you go down and you choose any of the administration requests. If you have any of these that you would need to be looked at, you would then choose either you want to update your academic status update, you want to do amendment of registration details, you want to do anything to do with graduation, graduation letters, or non-applicable if this doesn't help you or you don't want to address anything to this criteria. You can also look at student appointment claims or subject recognition or exemption. So that is the options you can choose under academic administration. So you could also choose non-applicable if it is nothing that you want to address from that. Then last, you would then choose your subject which you're querying for, and this is for IT department students. So you choose any of the subjects that you want to query for. So let's say it is IT fundamentals. You choose your level of study that you're doing that course for, which would be first year in this case, and then the offering type, which is either full-time, part-time, or if it's a short course. So you choose full-time, and then you give your subject query description. So you say your line here, you say your summary, you put the what you want to query about, and then in the bottom of this text box, you would then put in your the reason and your details of the query. You can also add images. You can insert videos if you need to, if you want to record yourself. You could also insert a attachment, right? So you can choose to choose an attachment, and you can add in a PDF form, Word document, anything that you think is relevant that you need to attach, you can attach an attachment. After you've done, for security reasons, to validate that you're not a robot, you need to put in this code here, which is 24EE9, and this would be a random code that would randomize, and it won't be the same for the next ticket. So you need to enter that into as shown in the image, and then you go ahead and create your ticket. You will then be notified via email, by your chosen email that you've entered here, that your ticket has been corrected and a staff member or representative will follow up with your ticket. If you feel like you've done information wrong and you want to redo, before you create a ticket, you can just click reset. It will clear all your fields and then you can start all over. And if you feel like you don't want to do a ticket now, you can just hit cancel and that will take you back and cancel the ticket, right? So you have an option to do that as well. And let's say you've created a ticket and then you want to look at your ticket status. You go back to the home page and you want to view the status of a ticket. You go to status, you click on that. You would then enter your email address and your ticket number. And then you will get an email link to your email address. Right, so this should be the email address that you created the ticket from. You'll get an email address sent to that. And then the email address will give you the link and that will allow you to log into your to the ticket system and view your ticket status. If you end up at this page and you want to open up a new ticket, you can just go ahead and open up a new ticket. Right, and then you would repeat the process over and over again. So the very important part you need to know is you need to choose your correct department. If any of these are not applicable, you just have to choose your query that you're directing for. So this is very important. Your nature of your query, even if it's none of that, then you can say other. Academic administration specified, you can either say not applicable if any of these are not applicable to your decision. And then here, very important, you choose your subject, your level of study, and your offering type. Thank you.